saw the race. Could it be Browder and everyone in the office when you stopped screaming?
Well, it saved me a few minutes. Guess I'll speak to you later then.
How are you, Mum?
Oh, I couldn't be prouder, Cal. That was one hell of a race. Everyone in the office wouldn't stop screaming.
Shut up.
Honestly, the way you're driving, I think we're going to have to change your name.
What's you this time?
Cali Winner. You've got some bad, Cal.
Oh, okay. That is the kind of award-winning journalism that we really do need right now, but one race at a time, okay?
That sounds like Casper talking. Is he looking after you?
Yeah, always. Actually, I've got a meeting with him, but I'm running a bit late here, so I've got to dash, I'm sorry.
Oh, okay, sweetheart. Call me tonight and well done.
Yeah.
Hey boss, got another one for you. Davido?
Hi, just had the little call to catch up.
Wait. What kind is it where you are?
Doesn't matter. I wanted a report for the race.
Ah, right. I did ask them to send across all the data to you. Perhaps they forgot. I'll make sure to,
No, I've got it all here. Busy man, Andrea. I don't have time to read all that. How did you do
it? The car is running well. Data's solid. Whole team seems confident. And based on the forecasts, we're sticking to the original tire strategy as we discussed. So we'll see.
Good. And the boys?
Keeping to themselves, no fireworks. Aiden's been a bit quiet, but that's usually a good sign before a race. And Devon,
I've already spoken to Devon.
Oh. Right.
Well, keep up the good work. Good luck. I'm sure we'll speak up.
been making steady progress today, and Connor Sport needed to. They desperately need some results, and they could do without this. And look, there's chaos in that garage.
Absolutely, only three wheels on the car at the moment, Crofty. Aiden Jackson looks on in despair. Here comes that spare wheel now.
That's a long, long time to wait, just sat in the cockpit. What is going on down at Connor Sport?
Well, the tyre is finally out of the garage and on the car, and Aiden Jackson's back out of the race, but it's a long time in the pit, and that will cost them dearly.
What was that? How many places did I lose?
Okay, try not to worry about that, Aiden. Just focus on the race, get your head down, and let's put it back.
I'm sick of this!
We'll be right back.
7 is actually getting preferential treatment by the team. So do you think, is there any truth to that, or is it an unfair assumption?
It's a good question. Davidoff Butler may be funding the team, but he's a good man and he works hard to make sure they're healthy. So, no, I don't think so.
Well, Aidan, the list needs to get longer. Car reliability, you and Devon bumping wheels, and now we're shooting the pit lane. Huge mountain problems at Transport. Has there been any talk at all about what the team might do next season, considering that you and Devon don't seem to get along?
If I'm being honest, I'd be lying if I said I wasn't open to any offers next season. That's just business. So who knows what will happen next year.
And finally, I've got to ask you about this. Rumours have recently emerged that you will be playing a role in the next Rotherstone film.
Yeah, I'm super excited for it and I can't wait to see what I'm going to be doing. They approached me for a part and it sounds so fun. I can't wait for the start of the film.
Appreciate it, thank you.
Talk to me.
About what? You saw the race, right? What is there to say?
Thought you could do, blowing off your little steam.
What is even the point in wasting any more energy? It's not the car, it's the team. The team is the car. No one seems to care how much effort I'm putting into all of this.
Which is why you need to double down. Listen, I promised I wouldn't say anything, but the top three are talking.
What?
They've already reached out. Looks like there might be some last minute negotiations on the cards, but keep that to yourself, okay?
Yeah, of course.
No doubt there'll be some wrangling. You've contracted for another season, but your tenacity has been noticed.
Wow, I don't know what to say.
Don't say anything you're not supposed to know. I hate you, but Connor Sport. Just do me a favour.
Yeah, sure. What is it?
I need you to push as hard as you can to get as much out of you before I lose you to a better team. Can you do that for me?
Of course. No problem.
You know I'm here. Speak soon.
You saw it, right? The pit stop? How am I supposed to deal with that? I know. I want a chance to prove what I can do, though. In a top-tier seat. I deserve it. I've heard there might be interest. I can't stay here. Okay. Well, what would you do?
So, what if I could get him?
Well, I told him to try to stay calm, see out the season, and then go to the final team meeting, see if that changed his mind.
And where were you at this point?
Oh, I was busy getting Cali ready for the final race of the F2 season.
I know why you're calling, but make it quick, because I have to keep my head in the game.
Of course, darling, but it wouldn't be right if I didn't call to wish you luck.
Thanks, Mum, but luck really won't do anything. I need a clean strategy and just to keep my head, that's all.
Look, which you do, and you will. Just breathe, Cal, okay? You've already put the work in. Now all you need to do is get out there and do what you always do. Yeah?
Yeah, you're right.
Who knows? Bring this one home, I may even call your father to gloat a little.
Mom, not now.
Oh,
Abu Dhabi. A few different drivers in contention for the F2 Championship. But here's the favourite, Callie Mayer.
She's been so consistent this season, so fast. My money's on Mayer for the championship, no question.
If she can finish high enough, the title belongs to her. Hollywood, a star is born. Callie Mayer becomes the first woman ever to win the F2 championship.
Historic. Well, I mean, someone had to be the first. But I just hope that this shows that talent can get you as far as money.
And what about your dad? Has he called to congratulate you yet, Callie?
No. Next question.
Callie, what's it like being a woman in motorsports? We're sure everyone wants to know.
I don't know, John. What's it like being a man in journalism? Next question.
Hot-headed. Yes, for sure. But you know, that's kind of what you need in a driver. Let's not forget that Callie taking the championship was a big deal. You know, for the sport, but really for everyone. It was one of the proudest moments of my career. That was the first time I mentored anyone. Yeah. I was a little sad to be moving on.
So, have you already told Callie about your music?
Yes, of course. And I told her, you know, how I wished that I could take her with me. She understood.
And Aiden, did you tell him?
No, he was too busy.
Busy?
Preparing to tell the team that he was leaving Connorsport.
Good evening, everybody. Thank you for coming. I know Aiden had something he wanted to say, but first I have a matter I would like to address formally. It is no secret that I have been spread a little thin this season. I own the team, I run the team, it's a lot, okay? Which is why I will be stepping away from the principal role next season. I'll still be pushing Connorsport Racing to be the brand we know it can be, whilst the new principal will be laser focused on performance and results. And we have already found a man to step into that role. Caspar.
Thank you, everyone. Now, this is a big step up for me. I'm really looking forward to see what next season brings. It's truly an honor to be on board.
I am sorry for the dramatic nature of the announcement, okay? Humor the man who pays you. We all look forward to working with Casper, yes? Good. Then let us continue. Aiden, you had something you wanted to say? The floor is yours.
No, it's nothing. I just wanted to say, thank you, everybody, for all your hard work this year. And I'm really looking forward to next season, especially with Casper at the helm.
Being around affect you going into the 23 season?
I have bigger things going on than Casper.
Do you have any regrets about 2023? Anything you'd have done differently?
No, I'm in a good place now. Besides, what's to regret about being the story of the season? Business.
Same as ever, hiring and firing. How's racing?
Oh, you know, ducking and driving.
Fair.
Of course, I've double-checked the strategy changes. I'm just going over my notes now. Everything's covered, just like always. They won't see me for dust.
You've spoken like a true butler. Just remember, we've got a lot on the line this season.
Yeah, I know. Finding these second-rate drivers, I can't do all the work.
Just remember where we've been.
trust me, Dad. You've got nothing to worry about.
Devon. I mean, you don't bring your A game. It's back to the bottom of the pile. Do you really want that?
No. No, I don't.
Just keep it in mind. And go out there and show me what you can do.
Already on it. I'll get you those points.
Today around the 3.36. Let's run you through the drive. 2020.
Okay, Devon, it's a brand new season, you know that, so let's start it as we mean to go on, okay? Okay? Let's get out there, come on. trailing the car ahead by 8.2 seconds. Job on the turn in there, mate. Looks like a nice stop time. We're happy with that one. Look after these tyres now. You want to finish the race on this compound. Use overtake. 16th. Time last lap was a 1:37.5.
Everyone saw the problems we had with the car last season. Everyone saw that. Now this season, I get to drive a car that works, and surprise, surprise, I smashed it. Not rocket science.
Well, you've had your share of run-ins in the past with teammate Aiden Jackson. Crucial question is that behind you? How do you feel about him right now?
Fine. Look, the main difference between me and Aiden is I know how to take a joke. I personally want him to perform at his best, but whenever I try to give him just a little friendly advice, so personally, I mean, he is a very difficult man to have a conversation with. He's all right, you know, he's cool, but just very serious.
Well, Konnersport surprised everyone by appointing Kasper Ackermann as team principal this season. So how do you feel about taking orders from someone with a history?
Yeah, I'm not sure Kasper ever actually did, but you know what? I'm willing to let bygones be bygones. And maybe he'll apologize, finally, for giving such a hard time to us, and we can start afresh.
Well, you're embarking on a new year, but what would a successful season look like for you in 2023?
Well, call me delusional, but I'm going to really try to make Kasper Ackermann laugh at something. And if I can achieve it, I'll consider that a success for the season. No, it's good. You've got to have ambitious goals in this sport, so I'm aiming as high as humanly possible.
Thank you so much for your time.
Great race out there today, just in the highlights. Listen, I know we've had our run-ins and, well, last season was last season. Fresh start for the team. What do you say?
Oh, Jackson. Yeah, cheers, mate. Bin's over there. Yeah. Nice one.
How about the season just gone?
The 2023 season was completely different for Konnersport.
How so?
Well, the car, for one. We'd ironed out the most critical issues, and it was just starting to live up to its potential.
Can we talk about what happened with Devin?
Right, yeah.
Carrying Dean Devlin as well as the butler name. I couldn't be happier.
Yeah, went well.
Well? I can't wait to hear what those clowns Adam and Connor have to say.
Yeah.
Hmm? You okay, Devlin?
What? Oh, yeah, I'm fine. I'm just adrenaline, Dad. I really pushed it out there today, you know. I just need to simmer down a bit.